for security of human health, treatment of various ailments, we have the ancient Indian system of medicine, under which we have Ayurveda, we have Yunani, we have Siddha, we have homeopathy, and even yoga and naturopathy. Under Ayurveda, we talk of Dash Mool, 10 roots. Among 10 roots, the 5 trees are there whose roots are included for formulation. So these trees are Bel, Eagle Marmalas, Shivanaka, Orozylum Indicum, Patala, Stereospermum Personatum, and Gambhari, Melaina Arborea. Melaina Arborea has many Sanskrit names, which are 1,000 years old names, which is reflected by its beauty, by its unique quality of healing and other characters. For example, beautiful leaves, so it is also named as Bhadraparni, Shri Parni. Leaves have some kind of taste, although initially it is a little bitter, but after you chew the leaves and then you take butter, you will feel sweetness. So it is also called as Madhu Parnika. It has some link with treatment of cough also. So it is also known as Kashmiri. Kashmiri, and from this we have the English name as Kashmir tree, Kashmir teak, and even in down south in Kannada it is known as Kashmari. In Assamese language we call it as Gomri, but in Udiya from Bhadraparani the name is Bhodroparani. In Sanskrit we have other names also, because it has the yellowish brown flowers and they look very beautiful. So it is also known as Peet Rohini. Also Sarvato Bhadra, again reflecting its beauty of leaves. Also Krishna Vrinta is another Sanskrit name, and another is Mahakusumika. Kusum is Clytera oleosa, but Mahakusumika is Melaina Arborea. If we talk about Gadwali language in Uttarakhand, then it is called as Gambar, Gambhari. In Gujarati language, it is known as Shivan or Sivan. In Telugu, it is called as Adavi Gumdu. Tamil, Gumdi or Katnam or Kumil. In Bengali language, Khamri. In Punjabi, it is Kumhar. Marathi, Gamar ya Kashmiri, and Malayalam it is Kumil or Kumbil. In Dogri language it is Kasir. The word Kasir looks to be derived from the Kashmiri or Kashmiri or Kashmir. So the word is Kashir, Kasir. It has opposite leaves. It belongs to teak family, or we can say the Bana family, Nirgundi family, Barbinesi once, now clubbed under Pudina family, Lamiesi. Melaina arborea is found in our shivaliks, right from Jammu up to Assam. It is also found in Pakistan, Southeast Asia, down South India. Ayurvedic uses are many. It is useful for hair care, skin care, urinary trouble treatments, especially male and female reproductive system. They are useful for healthy sperm formation. It is the galactagogue, enhancing the milk in the nursing mother. Fruit powder can be taken even bark, even leaf and flower extract is recommended. Melaina arborea is useful for gastrointestinal troubles. It is useful for blood related problems. This is very useful for postal delivery care, for the cleansing of the urinary tracts, female reproductive system, providing immunity. The flowers are visited by sunbirds, especially the purple sunbird, scarlet sunbird. Even fruits are eaten by the wildlife, even barbets, bulbuls, white eyes. Melaina arborea is also known as a coom teak because its wood is also used in coom making. It is also used in madani, that is charnar. Wood is very useful for making the artificial limbs. Melaina arborea, this is a dashmool tree under the name Gambari. Its wood has use specially for the musical instruments, mathematical tables, carom boards, even blackboards. Wood is of high quality. It is next to teak, so it is called as Kashmir teak. We have many other species of Melaina. Melaina stands named after a German botanist, Johann Georg Melin. And then it was named after a species which was the Melaina asiatica, which has yellow flowers, golden yellow bell-shaped flowers and trilobed leaves. Another species which is found in our Jammu parks and gardens is Melaina hystrix or Melaina flippinens. In Australia also we have the Melaina species. For example, fasciculiflora is one species. Melaina fasciculiflora. This is found in Australia. We also find Melaina in Africa. And one species is found in China which is vulnerable, and it is called as Melaina haniensis. Another species which is found in Fiji and also in Australia is Melaina vitiensis. But most critical species under the genus Melaina is found in New Caledonia, which is Melaina lignum vitrium, which is critically endangered taxa. So it was named in botany as Melaina arborea only in the 18th century, whereas Ayurvedic and Sanskrit knowledge about the utilization of various parts, leaves, fruits, flowers, bark and root is 1000 years old. Nay, so our understanding about Melaina arborea is much older than the modern Western scientific knowledge regarding its utility as healthcare medicinal tree. Tree has beauty of its leaves. They look like people leaves, but in people we have leaves are smooth. Here they are hairy. And another character is leaves are opposite in Melaina arborea. They are born in pairs, whereas in people, Ashwath, Ficus religiosa, they are born singly. But both leaves have the long stalked leaves and they are heart shaped. So this Melaina arborea is also good for heart. It has special quality to treat our wounds and useful for skin care. So its seed oil is also useful as medicine. apart from seed, we can use the fresh fruit or dried fruit for keeping our body fit. So we need to understand this particular tree has lot of timber value, it has medicinal value, it has beautification, it attracts birds. So this need to be included in our afforestation programs, and it should be included in forest nurseries.